Okay, in continuation of the trigonometry which we have discussed, now let us discuss further. In this topic, we will try to find out the values of certain values of trigonometric ratios. So before that, let me just recapitulate. We have written sine theta, cos theta, tan theta, cosecant theta, secant theta, and cot theta. So we named this as perpendicular by hypotenuse. This is base by hypotenuse. This is perpendicular by base. This is reciprocal of sine theta, which is hypotenuse by perpendicular. This is hypotenuse by base, reciprocal of cos, and this is reciprocal of tan. Base by perpendicular. So one should remember this when you do the trigonometric problems. Now, first let us try to find out. We will here find out when theta is equal to 0, then 30, 45, 60, and 90. For all these values, we will try to find out the values of sine, cos, and all other trigonometric ratios. What I mean to say that we will try to find out the values of sine 0, sine 30, sine 45, sine 60, sine 90, and similarly for all the other ratios. Now, to find this one, suppose let us draw a triangle which is right angled isosceles triangle. Reference to see, this is perpendicular, this is base, and this is hypotenuse. AB is equal to x, BC should also be x, and then AC we can calculate it with the help of Pythagoras theorem, which is hypotenuse square is equal to perpendicular square plus base square. When we substitute the values, we will get x root 2. So here this has become x, this has become this, these are chosen as x, and this is x root 2. Now we can find out easily the ratios for all 45 degrees. So sine 45 is equal to perpendicular by hypotenuse. So here it is x by x root 2, which gives us 1 by root 2. This is the value of sine 45. Now cos 45 is nothing but base by hypotenuse. Here this is the base, which is also x, and hypotenuse is again x root 2, therefore 1 by root 2. Next, we write tan 45. So tan 45 is perpendicular by base, which is x by x, whose value is 1. Once we know these values, we can write the reciprocals of sine, reciprocals of cos, and reciprocal of tan. So reciprocal of sine, that's nothing but cosecant 45 should be root 2 by 1. Secant 45 should also be root 2 by 1. And cot 45 is equal to 1, because the reciprocal of 1 is 1. So in that way, with the help of this figure, right angled isosceles triangle, we are able to find out the ratios for 45 degrees. So this part is over now. Now let's talk about 30 and 60. For that, we should take a triangle which includes 30 and 60. So in a triangle, let's take that this is 30, this is 60. Then if you consider a construction here, let us extend this CB to D in such a way that the value of CB is equal to BD. That we can do it, of course. And join AD. Now, this is equal to this. As we said, that is 90 degrees right angle triangle. This should also be 90, because the two, sum of the two must be supplementary. So angle B on either side is 90. Now let's consider BC is X. According to our construction, BD should also be X. Now, if you take the triangle ABC and triangle ABD, AB is equal to AB because it is common side for both the two triangles. BC is equal to BD, that is by construction. And the included angle, angle ABC is equal to angle ABD is equal to 90. Therefore, from SAS congruency, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle ABD. That means this AC must be equal to AD. And angle C must be equal to angle D. That is, it becomes 60. If it becomes 60, then it should be 90 minus 60. Therefore, this is also 30, or otherwise PPCT also tells us the same. Now, this whole triangle, if you take ACD, then it becomes an equilateral triangle of the side X plus X, 2X. So, now that we know, in any right angle triangle consisting of 30 and 60 as the two other angles apart from 90 degrees, then the hypotenuse is twice the side opposite to 30 degrees. So this is 2x, this is x. Then according to Pythagoras theorem, this will be 4x square minus x square, which gives root 3 x square or x root 3. Now, once we know the three sides of a triangle, we can easily find out all the ratios. Now, let us write sine 60. For 60, this appears to be, that is A, B is perpendicular and BC is base. So sine 60 is equal to perpendicular by hypotenuse, which gives us perpendicular is root 3 or x root 3, and hypotenuse is 2x, therefore root 3 by 2. Now cos 60 is base by hypotenuse, therefore base here for 60, BC is the base, x by 2x, which is equal to 1 by 2. Now tan 60 is equal to perpendicular by base for 60 degrees. Perpendicular is root 3 times x. Base is x. Therefore, it is root 3. So, as sine and cosine are complementary to each other, this I can write it as cos 30. Even with we can verify it also. Cos 30 is base, that is root 3 x by hypotenuse root 2x. Similarly, this will be sine 30 and this will be secant and cosecant are complementary angles. So now here we can write cosecant 60, which is the reciprocal of sine 60, that is 2 by root 3, which is secant 30, because secant and cosecant are complementary angles. Now cosecant 30 is the reciprocal of sine 30, which is half, so it is here 2 by 1, that is equal to secant 60. So like that we could find all ratios for 60 and 30. Now two things are left out, one is 0, the other one is 90. Sine 0, so what is actually in any right angle triangle? Suppose if it is theta, sine theta is equal to the perpendicular by hypotenuse, AB by AC. Now, if I am continuously reducing this theta, then and when this A comes and touches this B, the theta becomes 0. So, as the perpendicular is becoming 0, this is perpendicular by hypotenuse. As the perpendicular becomes 0, when theta is equal to 0, then sine theta or sine 0 must also be equal to 0. But we said that sine and cosine are complementary to each other, therefore it should be cos 90. Now, what is sine 90? Sine 90 means in this case, this theta is becoming 90, that means these two continuously, this, that is the theta is increasing continuously, and when it becomes 90 degrees, then AB and that the line CA will move parallel to each other and then they are equal in size even. So in that case, perpendicular and hypotenuse are same, therefore sine 90 becomes 1, which is again cos 0. Once we know sine 0 as 0, cosec 0 is 1 by 0. That is 1 by 0. So it is not defined. Or we call it as infinity. So when cosec 0 is not defined, then automatically secant 90 is not defined, as the two angles are complementary to each other. Similarly, when cosec 90, which is reciprocal of sine 90, which is equal to 1, so that must be equal to secant 0. Now tan 0, so tan 0, what is it actually? Perpendicular by base. When this theta is becoming 0, then perpendicular becomes 0. That's what we have discussed. Therefore, tan 0 is equal to 0, which is equal to cot 90. And tan 90 is again tan 90 perpendicular by base. So when the perpendicular is continuously increasing, 90 means this angle is continuously increasing. That is, the length of the perpendicular is going up to infinity, and whereas base is a finite quantity, therefore tan 90, which is equal to cot 0. In this way, we could do all the trigonometric values for 30, 45, 0, 90, 60. All these things can be written in one particular table. So here we write the ratio, trigonometric ratio, and here we write 0, 30 in increasing order of angles, the value of angles, 45, 60, then 90. At first, let us write 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Just I am telling you how to write the table, how to construct the table. Now, you divide everything by 4. Then it becomes 0 by 4. This becomes 1 by 4. This becomes 2 by 4. This becomes 3 by 4. And this becomes 4 by 4. Now you take the roots for all. So this is anyway 0. This is 1 by 2. This is 1 by root 2. Because 2 2's are 4. So 1 by root 2. This becomes root 3 by 2. And this becomes 1. So here we have taken 0 to 4. Here we have divided everything by 4. And here we have taken root. Now this gives us the values for sin theta. Okay. Now cos theta, if I want to write, I simply write the reverse of it, because these are complementary angles. 1 root 3 by 2, 1 by root 2, 1 by 2, and then 0. Now tan. We know that sin theta is perpendicular by hypotenuse. Cos theta is base by hypotenuse. So if we divide sin theta by cos theta, we get perpendicular by base, which is again tan theta. So if I want to know the values of tan theta, I simply take the value of sin divided by take the value of cos. So 0 by 1, 0. Here it is 1 by root 3. And here it is 1, 1 by root 2 by 1 by root 2. And here it is root 3. And here it is not defined. Once we have written the values for sin, definitely we can write cosec theta, just reciprocal of it. Reciprocal of 0, reciprocal of 1 by 2, reciprocal of 1 by root 2, reciprocal of root 3 by 2, and reciprocal of 1. Then secant theta, just if I write the reverse of it, because they are complementary angles, 2 by root 3, root 2, 2, and infinity. Now cot theta is complementary angle for tan. Therefore, I should write this series in reverse order. So, infinity, then root 3, 1, 1 by root 3, then finally 1. So, if you understand these three steps, if you remember these three steps, then all the values, corresponding values, you can easily memorize it. So, this is the way how we learn the trigonometric ratios for the values 0, 30, 45, 60, and then 90.